Dearest friends and family, all those who believe in hope, and all who hold love as a cause worth giving every breath we have in service of, in every way, loved ones, all of you. We are gathered here today because in coming together we make this occasion a ceremony. We gather because Hillary and Tammy, here in this beautiful place, on the greatest lake, have made this a cherished day. We come together as people who have loved them separately, but now will love them together as one. And we come together to love them as something to believe in, because in their choice to be a partnership in marriage, they become the very best of humanity. A belief that we are part of something greater, that our choices every day are in service of good or no, that commitment and loyalty are virtues, that empathy and kindness are true, and that love is always the way. That in two joining together into one for the cause of love, we will stand our truest chance of becoming our greatest selves. We come together here on the shores of the greatest of great lakes, a body of water that has rolled on and on far beyond memory, that has been and seen the breaking of the world and its healing, whose waters have flowed deep and clear, fast and turbulent, slow and cloudy, beautiful beyond measure. Waters that have held countless people looking upon her in silence and peace, awe and hope. Waters that have carried hopes and have seen tragedy. Waters that have seen millions of sunrises and sunsets, and waters that have become us as we rise higher and higher towards what we hope to be. And so in many ways, this water is us. The story of us, the stuff of us, the love that is everything it is to be alive. And in all that it is, the allegory of marriage. I imagine now Hillary, strong and noble, clear and definite, beautiful and full of love, but love searching. And she is showing a few stars, maybe a few too many, standing on an ancient hard lava flow on the north shore of this great lake. The wind blows and the waves crash about her as she watches the sun rise out of the far horizon. And as the light breaks over the water, she hears what she has always longed to hear. And there's Tammy, strong, noble, clear and definite, beautiful and full of love herself, though also a love searching. And showing a few scars, maybe a few too many as well, on the soft, dune sand shores of the south shore. The wind blows and the waves roll in a long line of flowing sand stretching toward the horizon as she watches the sun rise out of the water, and as the first light breaks, she hears what she has always longed to hear. And here at the very point where these two shores meet, we now stand, and we come together in unity, and each hears aloud now that which came on the wind with the sunrise before. In the jar before Hillary is the water of the rugged and monumental North Shore. And in the water before Tammy is the soft sand water of the South Shore. And here, as this happened since long before us and will happen long after us, these two waters combine into one. And so become something, they become the greatest of all waters. Hillary and Tammy, please, together as one, we will join our waters in a moment. Just hold them for now. There you go. And we will join our waters. Join your bodies. Join your hearts. Join your souls. Join your families. Join your hurts. Join your pain. Join your joy. Join your scars, join your lows, and join your celebration. Join your mundane, and join your extravagance. Join your hopes, join your work, join your lives, join your love. And as you do so, please first you, Hillary, then you, Tammy, after, repeat after me the following, and pour your own water into the one, and finally now here, with us all here, you've always longed to hear. When I think upon my past, I think I loved you for many years before. You know me better than myself. Please teach me how to be what I was made to be. When I think upon my past, I think I loved you for many years before. You know me better than myself. Please teach me how to be what I was made to be. How to be what I was made to be. You won't.
Now, Hillary and Tammy ask you to read excerpts from the Supreme Court of America.